Welcome to My Generation, brought to you by South Shore Senior News. This is the show that focuses on local health and wellness, financial planning, elder law, senior fitness, and entertainment. However old or young you may be, My Generation would like to help you age well and enjoy yourself doing it. Here are your hosts, Patty Abbott and Tom Foy.
Welcome to My Generation, brought to you by the South Shore Senior News. I'm Tom Foy.
And I'm Patty Abbott. Good evening, everyone. Good to have you back, Tom, this week.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. I feel a lot better than I did last week. Hey, thanks for tuning in tonight. It's good to have you with us here on 95.9 FM WATD. As most of you already know, Patty and I are the publishers of the South Shore Senior News, the only publication for mature adults distributed free every month to more than 400 locations in 31 cities and towns here on the South Shore. Please pick up a copy of our July edition or visit our website, www.southshoresenior.com, to access all of our issues, as well as our audio links to all of our radio shows, plus a lot more. And we are now proud to report that our newspaper is now part of the live program at the Talking Information Center, so please listen for all of the stories, news, and informative articles as they are read aloud each month. You can listen to their broadcasts via their website, ticnetwork.org, and all shows are archived as well. Thanks to the folks at TIC for including us in their programming. We are also happy to announce that our shows are being aired as podcasts on iTunes, so please check out our new home there. In just a few moments, we will be talking with our guest, Elder Care Authority, Mark Friedman, President of Senior Helpers, Boston and South Shore. But first, it's time to check on Patty to see what's going on in the South Shore.
Well, certainly the summer is very busy, so I can just have time to say a couple of things. This Tuesday, I want to let you know, July 18th, AARP Massachusetts, their Fraud Watch Network has a free program at the Wareham Senior Center. The discussion will focus on how to spot and avoid identity theft and fraud so you can protect yourself and your family. The program is free and open to all. The presentation is from 10 to 11 in the morning at the Wareham Senior Center, 48 Marion Road in Wareham, this Tuesday. So do yourself a favor, go to the Fraud Watch. And the South Shore Arts Center is presenting Surfacing, an exhibit by Anne Giuliani at the Paul Pratt Memorial Library in Cohasset right through August 30th. So head over there to enjoy the beautiful mix of media this emerging artist uses to realize her images of nature and a changing environment. It's a great take for art lovers. And for theater lovers, West Side Story is being performed by the Players at the Priscilla Beach Theater in Plymouth right through July 22nd. And then they'll be presenting The Producers in August. So check out this wonderful little summer theater on Rocky Hill Road in Plymouth for a real taste of Broadway by the beach. And don't forget, this August, the 150th Marshfield Fair will be presented for 2 weeks. And on Tuesday, August 22nd, it's Senior Day. It's free. They have great activities, music, giveaways. You don't want to miss it. Tom and I will be there and looking forward to seeing you on August 22nd. And that's just some of what's happening around the South Shore coming up.
That's great, Patty. That's great. It is now my pleasure to introduce Elder Care Authority, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston and South Shore. Mark, it is nice to have you with us.
It's nice to be back.
So good to have you back, Mark. Lots has happened since the last time you were on the show with us. For those of you out there who read our newspaper every month, you know that Mark has had a column there for months now. Every month, a different take on senior care, different ways that things we need to talk about when we're talking about care for our elders and ourselves and our loved ones. And certainly you have put out lots of information that is so important. And I urge everyone to pick up a copy of the July issue because there's a great article there. It's called When Home is Not the Best Place to Be. And that's an interesting take because sometimes even though we want to stay at home, it's not really the best place to be. And you call it the art and science of transition care. That's an interesting take. Is it more art or science?
The truth is it's a lot of both. Mm. It's an interesting topic for an owner of a home care agency to talk about transition care for when home is not the right answer, because when home's not the right answer, we're no longer providing care. Mm. We still are very proactive with our clients, and we're very proactive with folks that come to us looking for care to evaluate whether it's the right answer for them. It's art and science because there's the process that you go through, you know, understanding each community, looking at the lease, looking at the financial requirements, looking at the physical space, those types of things. But there's also art. What's the environment of the building? What's the personality of the building? What's the priorities of the staff, the mission of the company that's behind it? What's the activity program like? And most importantly, who are your neighbors? Mm. You know, the folks that you're going to be doing those activities with, you know, going to meals with, sitting with in a community table or small tables, you know, in there. It's important to evaluate all of those things. You know, even buildings from the same company that are managed by the same company aren't going to be the same. The company is going to have a philosophy, but the building is going to have a personality, and you have to fit. Mm. It's like a recipe. So there's art aspects, there's science aspects. And we usually work with our families and folks that come to us at points of need to help them sort those two sets of questions out so they ask the right questions from the right perspective and then make a good decision based on the information they have.
Mm. Now, you own Senior Helpers, Boston and South Shore, so you cover a wide number of communities.
Right. We cover about 75 towns, municipalities in the greater Commonwealth. So the best way to think about it is we cover inside of 128 for the service by my North office up in Newton. Mm-hmm. And then our South Shore office in Norwell covers pretty much the entire South Shore down to the Plymouth line, out through Easton and Bridgewater up to Canton.
Right. And Tom and I like to consider you an authority in elder care because you've been doing this a while and you put your heart and soul into it in many ways. And recently, you were just recognized with a great award for your work in this field. So congratulations on that. And you do differentiate yourself from other organizations, other companies like yourself. If you just want to let our listeners know, what sets you apart?
I think a few things set us apart. One, I take my role very seriously because my parents and my wife's parents are 600 to 1300 miles away. So when we have an issue in our family, I need someone like me on the other end of the conversation.
Right.
Because none of the children are local for either of our families. So that's the first thing is I understand the people sitting across from our desk and what they're going through. The second thing is, and it was an article that we wrote in the South Shore Senior News on understanding what's under the hood.
Mm-hmm.
I believe very strongly in setting the bar high, not to the lowest common denominator, but the highest possible standard that should be met. So we've done that in my agency, and it's not always easy. And it makes for a more expensive operation, but it makes for better care, better consistency and confidence for our families. So one of the big pieces of it is all of our cases are nurse-led. What does that mean? It's not a nurse providing the care, but one of my team of nurses, I have five, are supervising the care. They're the ones meeting with the family, understanding what the needs are, documenting it in the form of a care plan. Getting the aides that are going to staff that case up and running, and then on an ongoing basis, managing that care for an ongoing level.
Mm. Well, that is great. Coming up, we'll hear more from our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston in South Shore. But first, a word from our sponsors that make this show possible. You'll listen to 95.9 FM WATD.
Looking for sound advice? That's the one thing you'll find at South Shore Hearing Center. They'll help you improve your hearing so you can reconnect with friends, family, and the world around you. When your hearing improves, your entire life will too. From the moment you walk in the door, the staff at South Shore Hearing Center will make you feel comfortable and in control. Through the hearing test and consultation process, the highly educated doctors of audiology at South Shore Hearing Center will assist you in finding the right solution that fits your budget and lifestyle. South Shore Hearing Center, located in South Weymouth's Stetson Medical Center and online at sshc.com. South Shore Hearing Center, trusted for sound advice for over 30 years. How often do you and your friends talk about caring for an aging parent? Where to turn for answers and when to have that next step conversation with your parents can be overwhelming. Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood at the Pine Hills in Plymouth understand. Locally owned, Northbridge Communities have been helping seniors and their families navigate that next step for over a decade. They know that you want the very best for your parent because they do too. They're dedicated to ensuring the highest quality of life for their residents and will help you decide what choice is right for you and your family. At Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood, families can choose from a full continuum of care, including independent living, assisted living, and Avita memory care. Enjoy farm-to-table dining, inspired art programs, scheduled transportation, and more. Visit today, just off Exit 5 and Exit 3 on Route 3. That's Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood at the Pine Hills. For more information, go to nextgenerationseniors.com. That's nextgenerationseniors.com.
Back then, he walked you down that aisle, showed you the true meaning of family, taught you the life lessons you teach your own kids today. But now, he could use a hand, and so could you. Thankfully, there's Senior Helpers. A Senior Helpers caregiver can help with housework, prepare meals, build a lasting relationship with your loved one, and support all personal needs.
Call Senior Helpers South Shore at 781-421-3123.
You're listening to My Generation, brought to you by the South Shore Senior News here on 95.9 FM WATD with your hosts Tom and Patty. We are back with our guest Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston and in South Shore. Welcome back.
Thank you.
And when we left for commercial, we were talking about what differentiates your organization from other companies out there. And we referred to an article you had written for Social Senior News called Know What's Under the Hood. And an educated consumer, of course, right, you need to be educated to know what's going on.
And this is so important because in the state of Massachusetts, there is no licensing. So just because you're using an agency, doesn't represent anything. That just means they're registered with the state as a business. So what we rely on is what's inside our company because there aren't standards anyone can rely on.
That's amazing. And I know you're working to change that.
I am. And I'll talk about that okay, in just a minute. The first thing I talked about was being nurse-led in the field,
yes,
which is oh so very important. But not just for the beginning of the case, but the ongoing aspect. We make monthly or more frequent visits, sometimes twice a week on our clients because their level of care requires it. So their skill dies on in addition to the care we provide. We have case managers that are well-trained in the issues of seniors and aging in place. The second thing we focus in on are caregivers. Our caregivers are fabulous. We have almost 280 of them now.
No kidding.
They are all full employees. They are all either home health aides or certified nursing assistants. We have a few who have that in aspiration, and they help us with some of our hands-off care cases, but we're going to take them through our own home health aide school that will be opening in the fall. The third piece is the training we give our caregivers, and it's both general and specialized. Our orientation, for example, is 2 full days covering 12 very specific topics that dealing with caring for someone in the home and aging in place to specialized issues of dementia care, Parkinson's care, diabetes care, recovery care, issues on medication, issues on nutrition. You know, and physical transfer procedures. We have a mock-up of a studio apartment in our office where, with a life-weighted dummy where we make sure our caregivers are comfortable with the aspects of physical care of somebody that's frail and trying to age in place. The fourth criteria we really focus on is the underlying business backdrop. These are the things you would just expect from everybody, but you don't know what you don't know, so you need to have the right set of questions to ask, which were highlighted in that article. You want a company whose aides are fully employed. That way you have no employment liability if something were to happen. You want to make sure they have the right liability protection if, God forbid, something would happen. You want to make sure that company has all of those things in place. And you want to understand their operational processes for call outs and things like that. That's one of the reasons you use an agency. And then their satisfaction guarantee. For example, for us, if a client isn't happy with a caregiver, they call us, we make a replacement. And if it's the right answer, we refund the cost of that shift so that, you know, things stay on the right plane. Matching a caregiver to a client is two things. Do they have the skills and is it a good fit? sometimes they have the right skills and they're not a good fit. Sometimes
that's the art and science part,
it's
too.
It's art and science of that. A lot of this world is art and science,
right.
Absolutely.
Right.
So those are the things we really rely on to differentiate us. And maybe the last thing are doing things like this. We think that an educated consumer is the best for everybody. So we spend a lot of time providing education for our families. Before the show, I told you how once a month in each office, we want to have a family information session that's open to the public, where folks can come that have an interest in this specific topic, and sometimes they'll just be broad general topics. We can't wait to start that when we get into our new office in Norwell at the end of this month.
Oh, that's exciting. So we'll be letting folks know about that too.
Absolutely.
Through the paper and through our show here. And as folks come into this realm of caregiving and going, employing a home service, there were so many questions that they don't even know how to navigate out
right.
there. So these articles are really great. You actually give questions to folks mm-hmm. when they're interviewing a home health service agency. So this is great information. And as you say, you don't know what you don't know.
Right. Right. It's interesting. We had a call from somebody who, we repost the articles. And we had a call from somebody that didn't live anywhere in the Boston area and had a series of questions. And we took the same time explaining the process to them that we did for somebody that we would potentially serve.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the category of, making sure all ships rise.
Right, right. That's a good thing. That's a good thing because certainly the South Shore, the seniors in the South Shore, the population is surging.
Right.
As we note this every show, I think, every day, 10,000 people in the country turn 65.
Right. And 85 to 90% want to age in place in their home.
Who doesn't? Yeah,
right.
Yeah. And as you said before the show, Mark, 85 is the new 65 because we're all healthier.
Right.
Our lives have changed so we can live into our 90s.
More.
More, as you're seeing.
Right.
In your work.
We have a number of centenarians in our client mix, and they're great. I was on the phone with one of our clients yesterday who called me, and she said she can't wait to get up and boogie. So it was quite a call.
Well, we saw some of those folks in May. One of the networking groups we belong to held a senior prom, a real senior prom, and they had such a great time dancing, jumping around, eating good food. So yeah, we have something to look forward to as we age. But it's good to know that folks like you are really taking a professional approach to this and making sure everybody is taken care of. And typically, I know you get calls from the daughters of their parents, and that's who you work with a lot.
Right. The daughters, demographically are most often the ones brought into making care decisions for their parents.
Mm.
It's still traditional gender-based roles from their parents' point of view. And we support them. It's a lot of questions, and we have to focus on it.
Mm-hmm.
And we give good answers. We give, the right information. We give access to the original information. And you don't make decisions like this in a rush. You do, unfortunately, make them in a crisis. The key is not to rush through the crisis. Take the time, get the information. There was a family that we worked with, and the real issue was home wasn't the right place. We provided short-term care while they figured out what the right answer was for community-based living. And that was fine. We were thrilled to be part of that process.
The good thing about you and your company is that you're very collaborative when people call, and you very much take on the advisory role with your experience and your expertise and knowledge, and you're not quick to push them in one direction or another. So I encourage folks to give you a call. Your number, Mark?
They can call the South Shore office at 781-421-3123. Or they can call our Newton office at 617-500-6999.
And there's also information on your website, lots of information there. And that is seniorhelpers.com/SouthShoreMA.
Oh,
and then
perfect.
The number. Yeah.
Hey, coming up, we will hear more from our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston and the South Shore. But a word from our sponsors that makes this show possible. You're listening to 95.9 FM, WATD.
Harbor Mortgage Solutions is a family-owned and operated mortgage business located in Braintree. The company specializes in educating senior homeowners on the pros, cons, and potential suitability of a reverse mortgage. frequently misunderstood, the FHA-insured reverse mortgage was developed for the special needs of seniors. For most seniors, they provide a far superior solution compared to more familiar home equity lines of credit offered by most banks. Although the benefits of reverse mortgages can be substantial, they are not for all seniors. The best way to determine suitability is to consult a certified professional. For a free copy of our brochure describing key considerations, call 781-843-5553 or download a copy from harbormortgage.com. Please call me, George Downey, at 781-843-5553 with any questions or visit our website, harbormortgage.com, for more information.
Harbor Mortgage Solutions, Inc. is a licensed mortgage broker, NMLS number 2846, Massachusetts number MB2846, and Rhode Island number 2004181LB. George Downey is a certified reverse mortgage professional, NMLS number 10239.
Hey, you're listening to My Generation, brought to you by the South Shore Senior News here on 95.9 FM, WATD, with your host Tom and Patty, and we are back with Mark Friedman of Senior Helpers Boston and South Shore.
Yes, and just before the break, we had a great discussion, and now I think I want to focus on something you wrote about recently, Mark. You wrote about the fact that there is an Older American Month, and I think it's in May, and this year's theme is Age Out Loud. And you say that it speaks volumes about our seniors, the vibrancy they continue to exercise over their lives and the communities that care about them. And you wrote a great article about why aging out loud takes a community of care.
It really does. Needs are not, you know, black and white.
Right.
You know, and they're not necessarily consistent. Some are, but some aren't. And this idea of aging out loud, loud and proud, as my kids like to say, with some of their behavior, it's the aspect of, you know, not being afraid to ask for help. You know, that having, for example, an aide, one of ours, helping somebody, that doesn't keep their world small. That reopens it. It enables them to reaccess things in the community. We had one of our caregivers take one of our clients to see the tall ships from here on the South Shore. They drove into Boston Park,
wow,
and they went and saw the tall ships, and they had a wonderful day. Their world was large because they had extra support. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes it's, you know, for meals. Sometimes it's for personal care. Sometimes it's for reengaging in the community. I look back at my own grandmother who played Mahjong twice a week. Down in Virginia, and she stopped because she could no longer get back and forth and participate as well. But with a little help, that key part of her life, and it was my whole life that I remember her always playing, they had the timer right on the table. You know, maybe it would have extended a little longer for her, and her world would have stayed large for a longer period of time. We have more than 50 programs and services just for that. And just because people have a long-term progressive disease like dementia or Parkinson's doesn't mean their world is going to get smaller. The key is to take advantage of the opportunities in an appropriate way with the right kind of support so that they can continue to access the things that they love.
Right.
It doesn't matter what they are. We can sort that out. And the network of providers, and sometimes it's not just us. We need to call on expertise that we don't have inside our agency. And we bring that into the case. We introduce those folks to the family. And together we create a plan to age out loud.
Mm. And certainly isolation is a big problem with older Americans today.
It really is. Mm. You know, whether it's just going to the market to get food and groceries, whether it's to go to the community center or go to vote.
Right.
You know, it could be anything, or just to go enjoy the sun or look at where we live. Go see the beach to have the sand in your toes, even if it's just for a few moments. It's a wonderful place that we have, and this is the time of year to really enjoy it, to watch the leaves turn, to not be shut in and be isolated in your home.
Because isolation leads to problems on its own.
It really does. And, you know, so many of our clients, they're kids. You know, folks don't stay local the way they did where they grew up. There's still a large population here that does. We have a lot of clients whose oldest children or children don't live anywhere in the general area. The same situation I'm in with my parents. I rely on that larger network of where they are and being able to make sure their world stays large. And it's a very important thing.
It's important to know that you're here, in this case, for those folks.
Right.
And that their parents or their loved ones are having those experiences. Right. They're not shut in. They're not isolated, turning in on themselves, right. depressed, getting even sicker. So it's a great service. And also for the caregivers.
The family caregivers, are local, the family caregivers, you can't underestimate the role that they play. And it's a beautiful role that they play, and it's a beautiful journey they're on, but it can also be exhausting.
As an oldest daughter, I had that experience with my mom. She was young when she passed, but it was a lot of work, exhausting.
And you're a professional. Mm-hmm. You had a work career, a family, mm-hmm. And you're trying to find that balance, and those things are hard to manage and bring together. Mm-hmm. I won't give it away, but that's some of the topics of this month's article.
Ooh, okay.
In there to read, to talk about those demographic statistics.
Yeah.
You can't do that full time. You can't work 168 hours taking care of a loved one and still have the semblance of a life that you need to stay balanced and whole.
No, and then you need help.
That's exactly right. Or the well spouse can't take care of the spouse that has needs like that. They end up not well also. So for some families, we just provide respite care.
That's a wonderful
service. 2 days
a
week.
Yes.
We talked previously about longer term care needs, that you could forecast. You can say it's permanent, it's this. We have a lot of clients for whom it's a short term need. They need help post recovery, hospital stay or short term rehab stay, mm-hmm. which I'm hoping we can talk about in just a few minutes. They may need help because they're getting over just an illness, or their primary caregiver has to go away. We have one client we take care of whenever the daughter with whom they live goes on a business trip.
Mm-hmm.
We're there, and we have caregivers that are familiar with the case. It's not necessarily 24 hours times an hourly rate times 7 days a week. For some, it's 3 hours once a week, and for some, it is a much more complex care, and for some, it's an event-based need.
Right, and I think there's a prevailing notion out there that if I don't do this, I'm weak or I'm not the good, dutiful daughter, and I think that has to change too.
It absolutely.
You must run into that.
We run into it all the time. The first thing I do when I give a speech or a seminar, I ask how many oldest daughters are in the audience and ask them to raise their
really?
Hand. And then I ask them how many have been involved in care for a loved one. And the first thing I do is apologize as a brother. Because I know my parents are going to turn to my sister, even though professionally I'm more prepared to provide that role mm-hmm. for them. It's just the nature of family dynamics sometimes. So I really call on the brothers to step up.
Mm-hmm.
And be there, not just for short-term decisions, but to really get involved in the process and understand what's going on. And we have some wonderful sons that we work
good to
with,
hear.
And I will call them out that are just doing Herculean tasks to try to care for their parents. So it's not universal, but I will call on my brethren to step up their game a little bit.
Good, that's good to hear, Mark. Take the burden off of us older. Daughters for a while.
No, I know you had your hands full years ago.
I did. And years ago, we didn't have these options that we have today.
No.
Really don't.
You would hire somebody you knew, to come in and help for a little while, and there wasn't necessarily formal training. But with that aspect of aging, 85 being the new 65, yes and no. Because certain health attributes continue to progress. Hearing loss is more pronounced. Things like tinnitus. Mm-hmm. Progression of dementia lasts longer and deeper into the disease. Mm. Same thing with Parkinson's. And just the cognitive aspects of normal aging or being a frail elder. It's one thing to be, 85 and have limited mobility. It's another thing to be 100 and have limited mobility.
Mm.
And making sure there's a trained professional there to help and that can handle those things the right way and know the signs of we need to make a call. This is not normal aging. Mm. We do a lot of education with our caregivers on normal aging.
Mm-hmm.
Because normal aging at 65 is different than normal aging at 85, which is different than normal aging at 95, which is different than normal aging at 100. So there are different levels of alarms you have to be able to set for
and
those things.
Those are shifting too, I suspect.
They are shifting every day.
Every day. It's amazing. How do you keep up with all of this? But you have the practical knowledge, and you're out in the field every day, and you gather information, and you do a great job with that.
We do, and I rely wholeheartedly on my fantastic team of nurses.
You keep saying that, so I know you're proud of them, and they do a great job for you.
They are phenomenal, and their eyes on is what gives me the ability to sleep.
Yeah. And yeah, you're only as good as your weakest link, right?
Right. They're my strongest.
Yeah. And when someone will call you, typically what's the call you get?
It varies. We get calls for folks that, you know, want to age in place and there's a small need. They just need a little bit of support. That's category one.
And they know that's all they need.
And they know that's all they need. And we sit down. We still do the same full nursing intake. You get a full assessment, understanding everything from medication to nutrition and everything else, because we want to understand that care in the context of the bigger picture of that person. It's got to be individualized. For us, client-centered. In the hospitals, you hear the term patient-centered. So we really do focus on that. It's the same intake for somebody that needs 24-hour care as that's having 4 hours once a week. Mm. All right? So that's the first step of that. So that's category one. A small need could be errands, transportation. It could be 3 days a week because we need to help mom with her personal care. We want to make sure she's, you know, showered and able to go out in the community, events, things like that. Mm. The second category of care is aging in place, and they need a larger set of care, a larger portfolio of care. It could be 10 hours a day, 8 hours a day, 12 hours a day, up to 24 hours a day. So that's the next category. Again, the same intake, patient-centered care plan. Typically, those are more complex cases. There may be disease-based, Parkinson's or dementia or something like that. Mm. The third type of call we get are short-term needs, and there are two pieces of that. It could be somebody traveling, and we need support for while they're away to provide care for mom or dad. And the other aspect is a program that we are so very proud of, and I'm hoping we can get into a little detail on, our Going Home Safe program, which is a program specifically designed to help clients manage their recovery, because one in five people in the state of Massachusetts, almost one in five, numbers have fallen a little bit, ends up making a round trip. So they're discharged from the hospital or the short-term rehab, and they end up having to go back. And in most cases, that's preventable. We've designed a program specifically to work with our partners in care to make that number almost negligible.
So you're seeing that happen?
We're seeing that happen in the care that we provide, and our program has several legs that it stands on. It starts with certification. So we have become nationally certified by the National Readmission Prevention Collaborative. We're very proud of that.
Your company has.
Our company has. Okay. Senior Helpers Boston and South Shore. We're the first ones in Senior Helpers to do it, and we're the only ones in Massachusetts with the certification.
That's wonderful.
And that program is built around the following components. The first is professional education. I've written and I give a two-hour continuing education unit for social workers and nurses on the bigger aspect of recovery care and readmission management and the things that they can do to help make sure that family is informed and prepared. We don't stop there. The next piece is comprehensive family education. So before their discharge, they have the knowledge and the tools to orchestrate their own recovery care at home so they can make very good fact-based decisions on, do I need extra help? If so, what kind, how much, and when in there? And we lead them through a whole process, which includes a workbook that they go through and they leave, and it becomes kind of their guidebook for post-recovery.
That's a huge tool. I love that you have
it
that.
It really is a huge tool.
Did you put that together?
We did. We did put it together
locally. So it's your proprietary?
It is. It is. The third piece is we train our caregivers for it. They're trained on the aspects of the major issues affecting readmission as well as general recovery. And they have a specific classroom-based training taught by one of our nurses that they go through, as well as some online supports to learn what the issues are. So if it's a knee or hip replacement, if it's heart failure, if it's diabetes, what is it? They know what the profile is and what to look for and how to intervene. And the last piece is that case management piece that comes for the ongoing care. Most of the time, that's a 1 week or 2 week need, and then it tapers down, and we may be completely out of that case in 2 weeks to 4 weeks. Other times it tapers down but it becomes a longer-term piece of care over a long period of time.
Yeah.
We're very proud of that program, and we just launched it. Our accreditation came through last month. You may have seen the press release, and it's the major topic of a lot of our writings, our publication, and our community education right now.
And the staff must be so excited about it.
They are, yeah. Because it's the first of its kind in the entire Massachusetts
And they're really making
area.
A difference.
It's making a huge difference.
So give us a typical scenario of someone who may go into the hospital for a hip replacement. If they come out, there's a chance they could go back in because they're not getting the proper transitional care at home.
Right.
So you're bridging that gap, and you're keeping them at home.
We're bridging that gap, and we're making sure they check the boxes of the things they have to do. So it could be medication administration and compliance.
Mm-hmm.
It could be exercise routine, nutritional compliance, getting to the doctor's appointments. All of our caregivers can drive our clients, so making sure they get to their follow-up doctor's appointments. That's a really big if the son or the daughter lives 600 miles away,
right?
You know, in there. It's got multiple aspects, and it's tailored. Again, it's client-specific. It's client-centric to make sure that exactly what that individual needs is what's there. So we have the big picture, and we tailor it down to exactly what that individual needs, with our goal of making sure they recover and establish as close to their old norm or better, or whatever their new norm is going to be. They get there fast, they get there secure, and they get there without roadblocks or stumbles on the way.
So this seems like it's the wave of the future, and you're on that cusp, because that's you, Mark. You're always looking for the next biggest, best thing to help your clients. So you're really there. It's great.
It is our goal. And sometimes I learn from my own life lessons, being a distant child. You know, what are the things that would have made that journey easier for me?
So what are you hearing from the loved ones?
The loved ones are, one, grateful. Two, they didn't realize what they didn't know. And so sometimes that can be overwhelming. It can feel like you're drinking from a fire hose in there. So we try to keep it simple. We try to keep it straightforward. We ask a lot of questions. So we give them the information they need, not the information they don't need. But the real critical piece is that partners in care. For the hospitals we work with, or the short-term rehabs that we work with, is to start that education process, almost that admission, so that by the time they're ready to go home, they're ready for that next stage of the journey. And there's no surprises. They're not in crisis, but they're well-informed, they're well-prepared, and they've made deliberate decisions, not decisions in a crisis.
Yeah, that's important. And I know that so many of us wait for a crisis before we act, which is not necessarily the best time. But
it's not, but we're there for those
folks,
too.
But you're there as well.
And we do a lot of that, and we'll continue to be there for those folks.
Good thing.
That's great, Mark. Hey, coming up, we'll hear more from our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Help is Boston in the South Shore. But now a word from our sponsors that make this show possible. You'll listen to 95.9 FM WATD.
King Optical of Braintree offers you the ability to have your sunglasses ready in the blink of an eye. No more fumbling with clip-ons or juggling two sets of glasses. King Optical now offers the latest product from Transitions Lenses, Transitions Vantage. Transitions are the famous lenses that grow darker as your surroundings grow brighter. Transitions Vantage are a polarized version that reduce glare, produce richer, more vibrant colors, and make your vision crisper. See for yourself at King Optical, 20 West School Street in Braintree. Online at kingoptical.net.
Looking for sound advice? That's the one thing you'll find at South Shore Hearing Center. They'll help you improve your hearing so you can reconnect with friends, family, and the world around you. When your hearing improves, your entire life will too. From the moment you walk in the door, the staff at South Shore Hearing Center will make you feel comfortable and in control. Through the hearing test and consultation process, the highly educated doctors of audiology at South Shore Hearing Center will assist you in finding the right solution that fits your budget and lifestyle. South Shore Hearing Center, located in South Weymouth's Stetson Medical Center and online at sshc.com. South Shore Hearing Center, trusted for sound advice for over 30 years.
We're back with our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Help is Boston in South Shore. Mark, welcome back.
Thank you.
Where did everybody go?
I think for this next segment, I think we need to talk about your checklist for recovering at home, because that is making life much easier for folks that you're dealing with.
It is. I talked about the family workshops that we do on a formal basis, but we also get those calls in crisis. And we always make everybody take a a step back and a deep breath.
I was going to say that. You need, in times of crisis, you need someone to tell you that.
Well, you do.
Yeah.
You do. And it doesn't mean it can't happen fast. We had a family a bit in crisis this weekend. Mm-hmm. Came up on Friday, weren't sure. Saturday went forward. We started care Monday morning at 7 a.m., but we did it with control in there. And that's the key. The checklist is a tool that we give families, so that they can understand the path that they're on and the things that we're doing and why. Because one thing that's very unique about the generation that's providing care for the parents is they don't just want the answer, they want to understand the why behind it. So you have to take the time to step back and show them the big picture, which we're thrilled to do because it makes for a better client company partnership in managing care. So we have checklists for a lot of things. On our Going Home Safe program, we have a checklist to really manage that recovery care process. Because for a client, it's about recovery. You're not planning on being readmitted anyway. But for the trade, the hospitals, the SNFs, the accountable care organizations, they're very worried about a set of metrics that control how they get paid by insurance companies or Medicare or Medicaid in there. And they call it readmission management. We talk about recovery, and the goal of our recovery care program is to eliminate
readmission.
Right. We're not perfect, but sometimes, it's for the right reasons, and that's the right answer. So we've developed a checklist on that.
So was this a program that Senior Helpers had?
No, it's a program that I wrote locally.
Okay,
I did work with a couple of other owners in the system, but we did it. We pulled it together. I've given it over to Senior Helpers, and their goal is to slowly roll it out over the course of the next year.
The Senior Helpers is national.
It's a national franchise organization. Mm-hmm. I own the local business. I'm one of their top 10 in the country in terms of size and depth and breadth. Mm-hmm. And I've worked very hard over the last 5 years. I sat as president of their owners council and chaired the service and offer committee for 4 of those 5 years and have worked on a number of our national offerings. This is one we developed totally locally, and I'm very proud of it. Not because of that. I'm proud of it because the impact it makes
it's
for
working.
Our clients.
It's
it works.
Yeah.
It works.
And it's being adopted nationally.
Yes.
That's amazing,
yes.
Mark. Yeah.
I'm very, very happy with that.
Yeah.
I'm very happy with that.
That we have this resource on the South Shore before the rest of the country.
That's great. I've got a lot of learning points from my clients. Mm-hmm. We've learned by doing, but we've captured those learnings to make sure that if we learn something from client one, client two doesn't have to suffer that process. We codify it, we build it back into our business, and we move forward and up from there. The checklist is a key part. Let me talk a little bit about it. I'm not going to use any medical acronyms or the process names or models or anything like that. I'm going to put it in plain, nice English. Transition planning. How do you get from point A to point B, and what are the goals at point B? Make it very simple. What are the steps that have to take place? Whether it's just getting home from the rehab and getting set up in home, what does that look like? Well, has anybody been in that house, for example, in 4 weeks? Does the refrigerator need to be cleaned out? Trash? Do loose cords need to be picked up? Rugs? Is the house ready for mom or dad or aunt or uncle or spouse to come home? That's a really key piece. What are the specific things that need to take place in that house?
Something
home
you
modifications.
Don't think about because you're too worried about getting them home.
Well, that's right.
Yeah.
There's a grab bar in the shower. Do you know if it's secured into the stud of the wall or is it just screwed into the tile?
Right.
The last thing you want to do is slip and fall and be holding that grab bar while
right
you're on
back
the floor.
In. Right.
Right. The second piece of that transition plan is the care plan. This is where my amazing nursing staff comes in because they're going to go to the discharge meeting. They're going to review the chart. They're going to talk to the discharge planner. They may even talk to the nutritionist and the rehab department to understand exactly what needs to happen in home because we're going to be there. Yes, there may be home health services or VNA services, but that's therapeutic-based, event-based support, an hour for PT, an hour for occupational therapy. It's not ongoing care or meal preparation or those things. The second piece on that checklist is patient and family education and engagement. We need to make sure they're engaged in that recovery process so they understand, one, who's doing what, two, what are they doing, and three, why, and also to understand what's their role in that process and to make sure it's well charted out. Even calendared. We go through an actual calendar process, so we make sure we know like with Abbott and Costello's comedy on Who's On First.
Right.
Right? Third piece we focus on is medication management. If you've been to the hospital or you've been to the rehab and you go home, you have the medication list you have there, some of your leftover meds that were already dispensed. You still have all the medication that you had at home. It's still sitting there.
Yeah.
So that needs to be reconciled, and yes, what your new meds need to be, that needs to be set up and planned and put in a pill planner or whatever system we're going to use.
It's a dangerous situation.
It is a dangerous situation.
Yeah.
Because pill colors could change. Dosages might have changed. New med might be in. Old med might be out. It's confusing. My dad's a retired pharmacist, and I watch him do his med planners every month. And I've seen him stop, unsort them, start over in there. It's confusing. And he's a trained professional.
Yeah.
He only recently retired. So med management is key. But then also translating that to the med administration support that's needed if we're in there providing care, so our aides know which meds when, so they can provide the appropriate level of support and reminders to make sure that person gets their medication, that client gets their medication when they're supposed to. So as an example, some medication is absolutely time specific. If you have Parkinson's and you're in a medication routine, adherence to the schedule is critical because they may have a 30-minute lead time before they kick in, those types of things, or they have to be taken with certain kinds of meals. You can't let that vary. So we document that. We sort the medication. We make sure it's the right set and the caregivers have the right instruction. Fourth item on the checklist, follow-up care. Are those doctor's appointments made? Who's accountable for making them? When are they? How is the individual getting there? How are they getting back? I'll give you a great example. Some people often forget. Well, we're going to use transportation service XYZ, a taxi, the ride, whatever it is. Well, they get there. But that gets them to the door. It doesn't necessarily get them to the office.
True.
I've walked through some hospitals and it felt like a maze. You know, one of those summer corn mazes, those types of things. So not only the follow-up care, but making sure they get to the actual appointment. The fifth piece is the actual care in the home. Exactly what needs to happen. When? What's the bathing routine? What are the continence care requirements? What are the meal requirements? Those things. Sixth piece, making sure the broader healthcare team is engaged. That's not really our role, but that's where we would bring in an expert like a geriatric care manager, of which there's some wonderful ones here on the South Shore, if the family's not able to do that. And the seventh piece is to make sure everybody understands their role in the process so that everybody has accepted their level of accountability as well as the accountability to communicate with the other providers. And so sometimes we're hub central. Other times we bring in a professional to do that.
Wow, that's so much.
I know it is.
Real,
it is.
And you know, this is after you, this is a transitional time. And in your experience, it's 2 to 4 weeks sometimes, or?
It's usually that 2 to 4 weeks. The window everybody's concerned about is the first 30 days. The intense window is the first week, a little bit less intensity the second week, and then it tapers down. But for some people, it's a longer progression. Here's four things I'd leave with any listener. Be preemptive. Take charge of care. Don't rely on somebody else. And if you are relying on somebody else, make sure they know what they're doing. The second piece, get and maintain control of your environment, the living space. Make sure you know what has to be done there and don't leave yourself open for the accident. The third, keep the lines and flow of communication open between you, your providers, your family, your caregivers, your extended network of care. The fourth is use the information and the tools like the ones we're providing to decide where and how to fill in the gaps. You can be surgical. It's not 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's what's my need. We have some calendar activities that we do with our families to make sure that they're covering the red gaps, not the green gaps. Okay?
Very important information.
That's great information. Coming up, we'll hear more from our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston in the South Shore. We are Tom and Patty, and you are listening to My Generation on 95.9 FM, WATD.
Harbor Mortgage Solutions is a family-owned and operated mortgage business located in Braintree. The company specializes in educating senior homeowners on the pros, cons, and potential suitability of a reverse mortgage. frequently misunderstood, the FHA-insured reverse mortgage was developed for the special needs of seniors. For most seniors, they provide a far superior solution compared to more familiar home equity lines of credit offered by most banks. Although the benefits of reverse mortgages can be substantial, they are not for all seniors. The best way to determine suitability is to consult a certified professional. For a free copy of our brochure describing key considerations, call 781-843-5553 or download a copy from harbormortgage.com. Please call me, George Downey, at 781-843-5553 with any questions or visit our website, harbormortgage.com, for more information.
Harbor Mortgage Solutions, Inc. is a licensed mortgage broker, NMLS number 2846, Massachusetts number MB2846, and Rhode Island number 2004181LB. George Downey is a certified reverse mortgage professional, NMLS number 10239. How often do you and your friends talk about caring for an aging parent? Where to turn for answers and when to have that next step conversation with your parents can be overwhelming. Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood at the Pine Hills in Plymouth understand. Locally owned, Northbridge Communities have been helping seniors and their families navigate that next step for over a decade. They know that you want the very best for your parent because they do too. They're dedicated to ensuring the highest quality of life for their residents and will help you decide what choice is right for you and your family. At Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood, families can choose from a full continuum of care, including independent living, assisted living, and Avita memory care. Enjoy farm-to-table dining, inspired art programs, scheduled transportation, and more. Visit today, just off Exit 5 and Exit 3 on Route 3. That's Stafford Hill and Laurel Wood at the Pine Hills. For more information, go to NextGenerationSeniors.com. That's NextGenerationSeniors.com.
You're listening to My Generation, brought to you by the South Shore Senior News here on 95.9 FM, WATD, with your host Tom and Patty, and we are back with Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston and the South Shore, and welcome back again.
Thank you.
So this is our last segment, and I know, Mark, you were so passionate about seniors and healthcare, and I know the goal of your agency is to set a new standard in home care in Massachusetts, and from all accounts, you're doing that, and you're doing that in a big way. Because many of your new developments are being picked up nationally. So that's right. Great testament to the passion you have for this and what folks on the South Shore and all over Boston are taking advantage of now. And I know that there are so many folks out there who will come upon a crisis, or they're thinking about what's going to happen to mom or dad after they come out of the hospital with this procedure or that operation. And as you say, don't be afraid to ask questions, and right. Don't assume that you know what's best, or be afraid to ask anybody.
It's the first thing we tell folks, is make sure you ask a lot of questions. Don't be satisfied with the answer you got if you don't understand it. Ask for clarification. Get details.
No matter who you call.
No matter who you call. You know, people, I'll talk to folks and they'll say, was there another place I can go for information? And we'll point them to third-party resources.
Sure, there are lots of places.
There are lots of places. The biggest challenge we see folks using is Dr. Google.
Well, yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, I can go online and I can search that.
I'm guilty of that. I diagnose myself.
And Dr. Google didn't necessarily get certified in all the things. He's not an MD and he's not a PhD, all right? So you need to know where the right resources are and what they are and what to get from different ones. We provide that support, as do many others. This is an amazing place to live, the Boston metropolitan area. The information's here. The expertise is here. It can be overwhelming to navigate it. We do a professional education unit for social workers and nurses on navigating the elder care continuum, because we're in it. We're providing input to other people, but there's still a need to stay current, because things are changing all the time. Rules are changing. Providers are changing. Licensing regulations are changing. Priorities are changing across the healthcare continuum. All of those things impact that the right answer yesterday may be the wrong answer today. So you may have gone through something with dad 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago. And you're going something with mom today, and the same rules don't apply.
That's very true.
Mm-hmm. Get current. Yeah, yeah. Find out what the right answer. Make sure you have the information you need. And if not, access the professionals that can help you. But don't assume anything there either. Trust and verify before you trust anybody that you're using as a third-party provider. Ask the really tough questions. It's one of the reasons why a group of us formed the Home Care Association of America, Massachusetts chapter. We're advocating for a high standard because for us, it's about consumer protection. It's not about Medicaid rules or Medicare rules or those types of things. Our employees are treated well. They are paid well. This is about consumer protection. Mm-hmm. So if you have a caregiver in your home, you know what that means. You know what a background check is versus isn't. Mm-hmm. You understand what different training levels are and what they represent with regard to your care. You understand what case management means. You understand why a nurse or a social worker should provide that. And if you choose not to have those things, you're making that as an informed choice. Right. You have many choices. Make informed choices.
And that's all about know what's under the hood in that article.
Absolutely.
You wrote. And you have many of the questions there, what to ask,
right?
Which is very helpful. So again, go to SouthShoreSenior.com and look up Mark's articles, because you certainly have 10, 12 already there and more to come.
Right.
What are some of the topics you'll be covering?
We've got a few coming. This month's article is really going to focus on the plight of the family caregiver, mm-hmm. and what's going on there. It'll give some statistics for folks so they don't feel like they're overwhelmed without cause. Mm-hmm. They're in a pretty popular pool of people that are feeling the same way. We've got other topics. We're going to be doing more on recovering at home and the recovery care program. We're going to do more on Parkinson's, and we'll have some more on dementia. And you know, if something happens in my life as it relates to the seniors I'm working with, it may derail all of that, and we'll do something we feel is more prevalent.
That's
true.
We're
really trying to stay current based on the issues at hand that we see every day.
Mm. And you certainly are in the mix of that. So again, your phone numbers, Mark, for folks out there.
South Shore number, 781-421-3123. Our Newton number, 617-500-6999. Or you can look at our website, seniorhelpers.com/Boston.
All right. Thank you so much, Mark. This has been great.
Thank you.
It has been, and we want to thank our guest, Mark Friedman, owner of Senior Helpers Boston and South Shore, for joining us tonight. It's been a pleasure, and it's been very informative. Before we sign off, I just want to remind you about a great restaurant in Cohasset, the Blue Mussel Tavern. If you're taking in a show at the South Shore Music Circus this summer, as Patty and I are planning to do, it's the perfect spot for dinner before the light bite after the show. Or a light bite after the show, excuse me. It's just a mile from the tent. Chef Anthony Ambrose has some new summer menu items, including small plates priced under $10, and some terrific lobster specials also that you don't want to miss out on. And remember, they are open late, so enjoy it and tell them Tom and Patty sent you. Tune in next Sunday, as our guest will be Steve Anzoni, host of 95.9 FM WATD's radio program, Ready, Set, Retire Radio, and founder of Fairway Financial. We're Tom and Patty, and you're listening to My Generation, brought to you by the South Shore Senior News here at 95.9 FM WATD. Have a great week, and again, thanks, Mark, for being on the show.
Thank you.
People try to put us to down.
Talking about my generation.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
Take my generation. Take my generation, baby. Why don't you all fade away? Try and dig what we all say. I'm not trying to cause a big sensation. I'm just talking about my generation.